What's up, everybody? This your boy E, and welcome to my podcast, Let's Rap. Yeah, man. So I've been trying to figure out what I want my podcast to be about. And it's been taking me a while to figure it out, but today I figured it out, man. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to Facebook. I'm gonna look at different posts and status, and I'm gonna pick one that I vehemently disagree with, and I'm gonna make a whole video about it, telling you why I feel the way I do. Today we're gonna go with Chris Hill, man. He posted that the best receivers to ever play the game of football, the top three. Check this out. He had number one, Randy Moss. Number two, he had Jerry Rice. And number three, he had Terrell Owens. I'm not gonna lie to y'all. One through three, I have completely different. Like, I got the same three guys, but they are all in different positions. Like, it's pause. But okay, so number one, it's Jerry Rice. He the GOAT, man. I refer to him as the Michael Jordan of football. I used to before Tom won his sixth ring. So Tom has to be the GOAT of football, of course. But Jerry Rice is still the GOAT of wide receivers. Like, he's the greatest to ever lace them up. He has the most touchdowns, the most receiving yards of any wide receiver to ever lace them up. He has four Super Bowl rings, which is more than both of the other two guys combined. You know, and you can't take away what that man has accomplished on the field. He's one of the greatest to ever lace him up. The stories about this dude are legendary. They say his hands got so great because he worked with his father in the summertime, and they used to throw bricks at him. They used to dismantle walls and put walls up, and he was catching bricks with his hands to get his hands right. And, you know, whether that's a true story or some made up shit, it sound dope as fuck and it makes sense. So Jerry Rice, man, it goes without saying, you cannot have him below number one. Like, he don't have no blemishes on his record. Jerry Rice is the GOAT. Which brings me to number two. It's Terrell Owens. Without a shadow of a doubt, T.O. has more receiving touchdowns than Randy Moss. He has more receiving yards than Randy Moss. He has a better route tree than Randy Moss. He has a better feel for the game than Randy Moss. He has more intensity than Randy Moss. T.O. was not a one-trick pony. T.O. didn't just go out wide. He didn't go just across the middle. He didn't just do out routes. He did it all. T.O. is the man. Like, he would give it to you however you want it. However you want it, however you feel. However you want it, nigga. Like, he was gonna get it to you just like that. Now, he had, T.O. went to a Super Bowl on a fucking broken leg and went ape shit on a broken leg. Man, that's the stuff of legends. Legends. Not saying that the other guys ain't legends. He did something that was just ridiculous. And the fact that they didn't win it had no bearing on him. Everywhere T.O. went, he won. They won at a high level. From the 49ers to the Eagles. You know, maybe not when he got with Cincinnati or Buffalo, but that was later on in his career. But everything else about his stats show you that he was the man. Which brings me to number three, Randy Moss. Randy Moss was great. For sure. He was great. But Randy Moss was a one-trick pony. Randy Moss would go out wide every fucking time. He's going for the long ball every time. It has to be a home run, or he ain't doing shit for you. Randy Moss is not running across the middle. He wasn't no out routes. He wasn't twinkle toes on the sideline. Falling out of bounds. He wasn't doing none of that. He was straight out. If he wasn't getting that, then what was he doing for you? Which he was getting a lot of times, but he was a one-trick pony, man. So, which shows why, okay, he had early success with the Vikings. He had Chris Carter on the other side. So, even though Randy Moss was a one-trick pony, you had another Hall of Famer on the other side that allowed him to be great because you couldn't just focus on Randy the whole time. And then when you start focusing on Chris, Randy didn't get your ass. T.O. had Jerry, an older Jerry though. You know, he got to the 49ers in what, 97? 98? That was an older Jerry Rice right before he went to the Raiders. Randy Moss had a Chris Carter, you know, in the middle of doing his thing, Chris Carter. Like, you know, it's a clear-cut difference. Okay, so fast forward after that. You send Randy Moss to the Raiders. He did nothing. He did nothing for years. He did nothing. We damn near forgot about Randy Moss. Then what happened? He resurfaces. He's with the Patriots. The greatest to ever lace him up, Tom Brady. And then all of a sudden, they win 16 games. 16-0 in the regular season. And lose in the Super Bowl. Like, that's an L. You got to hold it. Like, what happened in the Super Bowl? You know, that wouldn't. I feel like that wouldn't have happened with T.O. I know it wouldn't have happened with T.O. Not if he had Tom. There's no way that would happen. He had too big of an impact on the game to lose in the Super Bowl with the greatest of all time with him. That just wouldn't have happened. When T.O. went to the Super Bowl, he had the best receiver that was with him, Freddie Mitchell. Yeah. So it's ridiculous. So it's not. And you had Donovan McNabb who got to the NFC Championship games like four times in a row and lost. But when they saw that they had T.O. back there. Like, oh, T.O. come back and we make it to the Super Bowl? All right, bet. We got a chance now. And they almost got that Super Bowl, man. So, and one of the biggest indictments of Randy Moss's career is that Randy Moss, check this out. He literally admitted this on camera. I play when I feel like it. Dude, you can't be the GOAT if you play when you feel like it. I'm sorry. That's not an argument. It's not an argument for a dude who plays when they feel like it. Man, if you the real GOAT, you feel like it every night. Unless you injured, you feel like it every night. You don't go out there and say, I'm a half-ass it. I'm not finna do what I'm supposed to do to help my team win. Nah, if you the real GOAT, you go out there and you get it done, man. Like, just point blank, period. You don't have nights where, hey, you're not feeling it. Nah, man, that's not gonna get it. So you can't be number one with that attitude. And you can't be number two with that attitude at all, you know? So, this is what I'm going to be doing, man. My podcast is just going to be me scrolling the net, surfing the net, seeing what people saying, and then me letting y'all know why I disagree with what they said, man. So, who knows, man? It might be your status next. It might be your post next. Who knows? I'm looking. If I agree, I might do videos with stuff that I agree with and expound upon what you said. But I'm definitely going to find the ones that I don't agree with and tell you why I don't agree with it. And I'm going to give you a shout out while I'm doing it. You know, nothing malicious at all, man. It's just something to talk about, man. And if y'all got some opinions on what I've said, if you disagree with what I said, man, just comment below, man, and subscribe, man, to Let's Rap, man. Appreciate y'all watching my video. I have a good one. We out.
Plenty racks in my jeans like it's tax time. Plenty racks in my jeans like it's tax time. Plenty racks in my jeans like it's tax time. Plenty racks in my jeans like it's tax time. Plenty.